Good morning, everyone. So today is Saturday, start of December, and you know what? I've not had a new car in a while. It's been like a while. Unfortunately, that means something has got to go, and it's probably the best car I've actually ever owned. It's the best one in the current fleet. It is the mighty 320D Compact, supplied by All Cars. A couple of reasons why, to be honest with you, I'm bored. The particular car I quite like, something I've always wanted to own for a decent length of time. Always been a bit too scared of owning one. I'll give you a bit of insight, you'll probably guess what it is in a matter of like seconds. So it has an LSD from stock, unless it's an automatic. It's, you know, economical. Oh, can't give a straight face on that. Doesn't use much oil. Yeah, who am I kidding on this one? And it's a 1.3. So now you know what it is, and you're thinking what I'm thinking. Oh no, what am I doing? But you know what? I've always wanted to own one. They're probably actually crap, but they look half decent. And then, you know what? I've got a said 20 let sitting there. You know kind of what I'm thinking on this one, but we'll see how it pan out. So, stay tuned. So, you probably worked out what it is. Looking at the interior of the car, you're probably now fully certain what it is. 2005 RX-8 231. 73,000 mile, good compression, no hot start, cold start issues to report. LSD on it, works phenomenal. First thing was, you know, sling its ass out. Happy on that. Do you need to sort the cat? The cat is fucked on the car, and it does need a couple of cosmetic bits. So far though, so good. Heat seat doesn't work. Need to sort obviously a little bit of corrosion out here and there. But yeah, it's okay. Now it isn't as fast as the compact. I knew it wasn't going to be, but I didn't want it for the power. I wanted it for the LSD. Now, you're thinking, you're an idiot, you should have waited to diff the compact. Bored of the compact. I've had it, you know, a while now for me. An RX-8's always been the car I've always wanted, but I've always been terrified to own. So, you know, I've got the 530, so I've got a couple of projects to play with. Wouldn't mind putting the Z20 LET in one of these. So if you know anyone who is handy or who feel confident on sorting this out, drop me a message. It is going to be a lot of fabrication work, a lot of wiring and a lot of fucking shit. But yeah, it's possibly something in the future. Anyway, I'm going to catch you later. I'm going to crack on this boring motorway and let you know how it goes. We are now 40 miles in. I think I need to get more fuel. I'm not even actually joking for once. Fucking drinks. Like, I can watch nearly the fuel gauge plummet down. Like, I'm getting really worried if I actually make it to the fuel station. I mean, we're doing 70 at 3,500 revs and 60. And I can watch the fuel gauge drop. Place your bets. So, yeah. And now see what Alex from Car Throttle had to go through. So, I've lowered the speed down. Fuel light is firmly on. I've got 10 miles to get to the nearest fuel station. I don't know how to work the onboard computer to see if it tells me my miles, gallon or range or anything like that. All I know is going to be bloody close. So yeah, first kind of hour into RX-8 life, and I'm already bricking it trying to find a fuel station. But yeah, my own fault, didn't put enough fuel in. thought compact could do it on fuel, put obviously double the amount in what I would in the compact, thinking that would be enough, and how wrong I am. So yeah. Has anyone got any toilet paper? So, pleased to report, I made it to a fuel station, Tesco 99. I stuck another 30 quid in, see what happens. So far, might actually be able to enjoy it, get on some decent roads and see what happens. So, finally managed to do it this year. For a 1.3, So, first impressions of how we do rotary. Very, very smooth revving. Pretty quiet, half decent exhaust note stock, but obviously that's not going to stay. Notice when you get over 7, you can feel like more of a power band come through. Then you get the beep on the dash, you know, keep it fucking pinned. Turning lock as well, really good. Must say though, it's a snappy fucking cunt. When you get it at a good angle, that fucking wants to really kind of. Well, is it? I don't know if it's me being BMW, but fucking hell, you make one mistake and that's fucking gonna bite you. Your views on that one, it could just be me, but I'd say the BM seems a lot more nicer to slide about. This seems more of a nasty cunt in the aspect that. Obviously you ain't got a lot of torque there and it just wants to fucking kill you, but so far though, I'm loving it. Righto, so I made it home after the adventure just. Also as well, I checked the oil and it was empty near enough, so it is true straight away. RX-8s love fuel and they love oil, so I haven't got very good example of RX-8, to be brutally honest with you. I'll run through with you why I think that, and you know, my overall impressions. So first of all, paint on the car is terrible. It looks like it's never had a polish in its life. Gave it a quick wash and it's pretty rough. Obviously stuck the number plate on because I want to be half legal. So front bumper tatty, headlights fucked. You can see what I mean by the paint, it's fucked. You've got all your typical RX-8 issues, steamed up back lights, cat's fucked. Interior though is relatively clean, amazingly. Not so fucked. Oh, heated seats fucked. You can kind of see where I'm going with this. First impressions though of driving the RX-8, really enjoy it. It seems a bit like the Range Rover, it's a love-hate kind of relationship. Now ultimately that is just a piss about car, that's obviously my favourite, and the combo question mark there on that one. But ultimately, you know, this episode is going to be living with a RX-8. So I have named the car already. It's quite an appropriate name, to be honest with you. I was thinking a range of different names and I'm gonna call it, I've changed my mind last minute, Shelly. So meet Shelly the RX-8. Reason why, it likes Shell sells oil, works with oil, and it's a wanker. Meet Cargo Flogs, Shelly.